Want to tag along with firefighters, see the reality of their jobs, and experience dangerous rescues and adrenaline-filled situations from the comfort of your home? Then you're in luck, because we've put together a collection of the best firefighter TV shows from the past and present. A quick disclaimer before we start. The TV series in this video are listed in no particular order, and from now on, a spoiler warning is in effect. With that out of the way, this is TV Show Pilot, and here are the 10 best TV shows about firefighters. Chicago Fire.
Smoke's already coming out pretty quick. We don't have long on this one. Engine 51, give me a 2.5 in the front door, cover the search team's truck. 81, open up the bag vent, the skylights, Kelly.
Chicago Fire is the pioneer series in Emmy Award-winning producer Dick Wolf's Chicago franchise. On the show, we're treated to a look into both the personal and professional lives of the firefighters, rescue squad, and paramedics in Firehouse 51 of the Chicago Fire Department. Firehouse 51 is a true family, and just like any family, the members of the firehouse have their share of drama and disagreements. But at the end of the day, the firehouse always comes together to serve and protect the citizens of Chicago. And once you're done binging Chicago Fire, get to know the other first responders of the One Chicago universe, with Chicago PD and Chicago Med, as well as Chicago Justice. Station 19.
Every life saved, every fire put out. We're Seattle firefighters.
Station 19 is the spinoff we never knew we needed until it premiered in March 2018. It has a lot to live up to, though, spinning off from the hugely successful Grey's Anatomy. But it's doing a pretty good job so far. Based on the title, this firefighter series follows the brave firefighters of Fire Station 19 of the Seattle Fire Department. From the station's captain down to the rookies of the team, Station 19 reflects the daily life and loss that the firefighters face while working in the busy city. And occasionally, we get treated to guest appearances from the staff of Gray Sloan Memorial Hospital, like Dr. Meredith Gray and Dr. Andrew DeLuca, to name a few. 911.
I will have officers at your door in under 2 minutes, okay? I really need you to try and stay on with me.
Fox's 911 doesn't just focus on firefighters, but also the paramedics, police officers, and 911 operators who work alongside them. You may need to prepare yourself a little bit before each episode, though, because these heroes find themselves in the most gut-wrenching and heart-stopping disasters. To give you an idea, Season 3 kicks off with a massive tsunami hitting Santa Monica, and our first responders are called in to save the day. On top of that, 911 also highlights the characters' personal lives and how they often come into play in their professional lives as well. With the brilliant minds of Ryan Murphy, Brad Falchuk, and Tim Minear, coupled with the acting chops of Angela Bassett and Peter Krause, 911 ticks all the boxes when it comes to action shows based on very real-life scenarios. 911 Lone Star.
How long do we have to get him out?
10 minutes at the most. That depends on the air pocket, but you also can't pull them out too fast. You can just rip them in half.
911 is undoubtedly a hit on its own, but its spin-off, 911 Lone Star, proves to be an even match for the parent series. After a tragedy strikes Austin's Firehouse 126, Rob Lowe's Captain Owen Strand relocates to Austin with his son to help rebuild the station from the ground up. After all, he's the only one in the country with that kind of experience. He had to do the same thing as the lone survivor of his station in Manhattan after the horrific events of 9/11. Slowly, Strand manages to bring together a team of qualified professionals that include the paramedics and a whole slew of new and experienced firefighters, including his son, TK. From the get-go, we get a taste of the personal and professional demons that Strand and his team have to deal with every day. Fire Country.
You don't want someone dying on your conscience. You'll never forgive yourself.
CBS's series Fire Country brings us a different take on the firefighter drama. Starring SEAL Team's Max Terriott, Fire Country follows Bodie Donovan, a young convict midway through his 5-year prison sentence, who signs up for a prison release firefighting program. In exchange for a reduced sentence, Bodie and his fellow convicts will help the firefighters of the California Department of Forestry and Fire Protection fight unpredictable and often devastating wildfires. But little does Bodie know that he will be paired up with his father, Vince, former friends, and other elite Cal Fire firefighters from his hometown, the same town where all his troubles began. Rescue Me. Similarly to 911 Lone Star, FX's Rescue Me tells the story of firefighters dealing with the aftermath of 9/11. Premiering just 3 years after the September 11th attacks, Rescue Me received critical acclaim and accolades for how it tackled topics on depression, alcoholism, PTSD, grief, loss, and post-9/11 trauma. Protagonist Tommy Gavin, played by Dennis Leary, is a veteran firefighter in New York City, and to say he has a troubled life is quite the understatement. Dealing with survivor's guilt and PTSD due to the loss of several dozen colleagues on 9/11, Gavin relapses into alcoholism. While he is undoubtedly brave and has a passion for saving lives, his less than pleasant personality means he doesn't have the best relationship with his family or his colleagues. But as we get to know him better throughout Rescue Me's 7 seasons, we start to understand the reasons for his hardened outlook on life. Tacoma FD.
It needs to stop raining.
Holy shit, what is that, a llama?
An alpaca. What's the difference?
A llama is bigger with longer ears, and alpacas get stuck in swing sets.
What sets True TV's Tacoma FD apart from the other shows on this list is the comedic spin it adopts. Created by and starring Kevin Heffernan and Steve Lemmy from the Broken Lizard comedy group, the hilarity starts with their characters' names, Chief McConkie and Captain Panizzi. Contrary to the drama and tear-jerking scenarios that unfold in the other shows on this list, these firefighters have a lot of free time on their hands, thanks in large part to them working in one of the wettest cities in America, Tacoma. When the fires go out before they can even get to them, these men find other things to do with their time that often puts them in mischievous and troublesome situations. Despite the antics, the creators wanted to make sure that their characters were still highly capable professionals, so many of the episodes are loosely based on real-life experiences of Heffernan's cousin, who is a firefighter. Emergency.
That help coming should be here in about 5 minutes. He could be behind that wall. So much timber jammed in there, I couldn't see a thing. Could be in a pocket, might not be buried at all.
Yeah, this wall goes.
In NBC's Emergency, we go way back in time to the 70s. Set at the fictional Fire Station 51 of the LA County Fire Department, the show focuses on John Roderick and Roy DeSoto, two young firefighter paramedics from Rescue Squad. Despite being fictional, most of the rescues conducted on the show are based on real stories from a real fire station's logbook. At the time the series aired, becoming a paramedic was just starting to gain popularity as a profession. Emergency was so iconic that it has been credited with influencing and expanding the EMS services in America. When it first aired in 1972, there were only 12 paramedic units in North America. But after the finale aired in 1977, several states had already expanded their services. The show's influence is so significant that after it ended, there were 6 additional TV movies based on the show, and some of the show's memorabilia have even made their way into the National Museum of American History and the Los Angeles County Fire Museum. London's Burning. The last two shows on our list move us across the Atlantic. The first, ITV's London's Burning, is set in the fictional Blackwall Fire Station of the London Fire Brigade. It premiered in 1988 and ran for 14 seasons before concluding in 2002, and was based on the original 2-hour TV movie of the same name. Although the original movie used dark humor to make light of serious issues, the series packed on more drama as the firefighters dealt with the job's difficulties, the psychological hardships they experience after particularly traumatic disasters, and the death of colleagues while on the job. If you are interested in seeing how the British firefighters respond to the disasters on their side of the pond, London's Burning is the show for you. The Smoke.
Okay, gentlemen, it's last orders at the fire set bar.
Let's go!
Lastly, Sky One's The Smoke is a show that we just couldn't leave out of this list. It ran for just 1 season back in 2014 and was canceled due to low viewership numbers, despite the show's warm reception. Much like London's Burning, the show features a team of London firefighters called the White Watch and their high-adrenaline adventures. Not only that, but the 8-episode season featured an ongoing storyline that was packed with enough drama and revenge to have viewers begging for more. Sadly, though, the open plot lines will never be resolved. But on the bright side, there was a pretty satisfying conclusion to the revenge story. Do you agree with our choices for these top TV shows about firefighters? Let us know in the comments. Check out TVShowPilot.com for the full list of the best firefighter TV shows. And don't forget to subscribe to the TV Show Pilot YouTube channel for more videos like this.